Ignition sequence starts. Six.
What's up, everybody? Anthony Sevens here. I just wanted to take a few moments to stand on my little soapboxed corner of the universe and talk with you about something real quick. You know, there's been a lot of negativity in the gaming community over the past 3 years, ever since all this shit came out like 3 years ago. And it's like, it's ridiculous. And this has been stated, you know, I'm not taking credit for standing up and saying something, but I'm standing up and agreeing with what a few other gamers, you know, people who are part of the community, some YouTubers have been saying about a lot of the bullshit going on out there. And yeah, this is like my follow-up to all of that. And I think it's time for us to wake the fuck up here, people. You have to understand something. Okay, these games, for those of you who have no clue what's going on, about 3.5 years ago, various arcade companies started to come out with at-home versions of arcade machines. They're much smaller, they're much lighter in weight, they use cheaper parts to kind of keep the cost down so that everybody can be able to afford to have some form of arcade machines in their homes. Well, some hardcore gamers, and not all of them, some hardcore gamers have taken it upon themselves to stand on their soapboxes and really degrade not only the merchandise and the machines themselves, and not only the companies that built the machines, but there are people out there within the gaming community that degrade each other so much. I mean, it really is. It's a form of bullying almost. You know, like there's a lot of people out there that think like, oh, I'm better than you because I can afford to be better than you. You know, type of attitudes. And it's just, it's ridiculous. Guys, gals, folks, it's video games, man. It's fucking video games. I mean, first of all, we need to be absolutely grateful that these companies have taken the time and the money to bring to us an at-home arcade gaming experience. You know, it's also important to understand, too, when these games were first introduced to the world, even to this day, they're not advertised as being the most hardcore shit that hardcore gamers could possibly want. It has never been advertised like that. I think the best representation of at-home arcade machines is, you know, usually around the holidays, or if you go right now to Home Shopping Network or QVC.com and you watch the little video of like really lame and boring people like playing video games poorly, and they're just sitting there like, this takes me back to my childhood, and you know, sitting at the arcade playing Asteroids for 7 hours, and it's just like this stupid, cheesy, at-home, family-friendly fun. That's all it was ever advertised to be. That's all it ever is. I mean, I think it's because of the pressuring negativity of a lot of people in the community that these arcade companies almost feel trapped. Like, I'm sitting there picturing in my head a lot of these companies kind of getting pissed at us, like, damn, we just wanted to invent something fun, and all these people are like harping on us, and they're up our asses about making things more hardcore and making this more authentic and making the size more authentic and the controls more authentic and all this other crazy bullshit that's costing the company a lot more time and a lot more money to, you know, give a small demographic of people, you know, this high-end, high-grade, expensive, fancy shit, which is like the company, they didn't set sail in that direction. And I can almost guarantee you, I bet you they were like, we're just going to keep this simple. We have a fantastic product. You know, we're fucking giving people Pac-Man in a fucking box with, with an arcade machine. You know, it's like, how hardcore do you need? And I understand people's complaints about, say, certain button and control configurations to be able to play the games properly. And there are some things that, like, legit, that even I bitch and moan about sometimes. But at the same time, I'm not trying to bring negativity into the community. I'm not trying to bring negativity or, like, down anybody's playing experience at all. Ever, because, you know, I'm going to put you inside of my head for a little bit, okay? Just even though, like, I consider myself to be a casual hardcore gamer, which means, like, I'm not competitive in, like, this desperate need to be first place or anything like that. When a game is first announced, I literally go, wow, that's fucking cool. That's really fucking awesome. And then if I'm able to afford it, then I go get it. Then I wait in anticipation for this game to get to my house, and I bust it open, and I take it out, and I put it together, and as long as I can turn the on-off switch to turn the power on, and as long as the controls work, you know, fucking right. It's a good time. I don't care what game it is. I have just as much fun playing Mortal Kombat as I do Pac-Man. And I think that it's great when you do have various members of the community that say, hey, do you like what you have right now? Well, we're making bits and pieces that can make your experience a little bit better. How about a 4-pound spring or an 8-way restrictor gate? Or how about some fun stickers or extra additions here and there to make your gaming experience fun? And those are the people that totally keep the community fun and happy and lively. But when it's just constantly... Again, everyone has a right to stand on their soapbox and to bitch and moan about various things, but there's no need for it to ever run into the extent of where we, the gamers, become bullies towards the companies and pressuring towards the companies and bullies towards other gamers. I mean, you wouldn't believe, like, some of the comments where it's like, there are people in this world that have a shitload of money. Whether they came into a small fortune, or whether they're using their retirement fund, or whether they just have really damn fucking good jobs. You know, and there are people out there with over 30 of these arcade machines sitting in their homes because they have these big mansions of homes, and they have the room, and they have the money to be able to do so, right? Then you move down to the casual blue-collar worker who's able to afford one of these machines every so often and build a nice little decent collection. But then there's people that live in small apartments, and they can only fit one or two of these machines. They could only afford one or two of these machines. And it's like, good for everybody. Good for everybody. But there are some people out there that just have to be fucking bullies about things. And they have to be like, I've got 30 machines. I'm fucking more hardcore and I'm better than everybody else. And, oh, if you can't afford more than 3 machines, then, oh, maybe you shouldn't have this as a hobby and you should get a better job. And like... What business is it of fucking yours? What kind of job that everybody fucking has? What business is it of yours that someone's only able to afford one or two games? Just because someone can only afford one or two games that makes them less hardcore of a gamer or a player than you? Like, what the fuck, man? You know, because I guarantee you there is somebody out there living in Zimbabwe in a little hut, and they've got one of these machines, and I bet you they're like the most passionate, dedicated, most hardcore fucking player on that game in the universe, and they would kick your ass any day as far as scores are concerned. I mean, folks, this boils back to what I'm originally trying to say. It's video games. It is all created in the name of pure family fun and enjoyment. And if you personally want to take your shit to a whole other level because you can afford to, that's totally cool. But there's no need to be a bully and or degrade people because you can afford more or that you because you have more knowledge about things than other people. It shouldn't be that way, but it's like that all the time, every day. You know, and it drives me up the fucking wall. You know, so my advice to you, to everybody, to the veterans of the gaming world, to the of the arcade game world, and to the newcomers, just have fun. You know, I don't remember ever going to arcades back in the late 80s or even throughout the 90s or even after my high school years. I never remember it being a, you know, in-person experience loaded with bullying and degrading. You know, because I came into the arcade with $5 and you came into the arcade with $5 and we're here to have a good time. And we're going to play the game together, and we pop in our quarters, and we fight each other, and whoever loses shakes the other person's hand, and good game, man, way to kick my ass, you know, way to be better than me in this moment, and I'm going to work hard, and we're going to play some more later on. Or you do, like, you know, you pop your quarters in and you team up with some complete stranger on a shooter game. And then, you know, you're trying to encourage each other, like, come on, I'll get the guys on this side of the screen and you get the guys on the left side. And it used to be arcade gaming back in the days used to be such a highly fun social experience. But it's turned into this elitist world of crazy nonsense and bullshit and people throwing hate and anger in all of the wrong fucking directions, you know? And, you know, yeah, sure, there are some things that even myself, I'll stand on my soapbox and I'll complain about, or there's certain just personal preferences that I may or may not like, and I love sharing my personal opinions with you guys on certain things to help you guide your decision so you know what you want to get, or you kind of get it, my personal experience before you get your personal experience. You know what I'm saying? But it's just nuts. Just have fun, okay? That's my message to everybody out there in the gaming world, in the at-home arcade world. Buy your shit, build a cool little corner of your house or a room or whatever, and just have fun and encourage each other to play more, because, you know, because when you're playing online with other people, the last thing I ever want is, like, I'm not playing with you because you're an asshole. Nobody should be being an asshole. It's video games. Thanks for tuning in. This is Anthony Seven signing off. Take care of yourself, take care of each other.